So in the last two classes we discuss numerical based on base classifier. Today we are going to discuss problems based on a decision tree. So for this I have analyzed this 19 question papers of different universities. So it includes question paper from Mumbai University, Pune University, Marathwada University. So I have found out that out of this 19 question paper, 15 are having question based on decision tree, and those 15 were numericals. And in the remaining 5 question papers, they have asked theory question based on decision tree, and the weightage of those numericals were from 8 marks to 12 marks. Okay, so this decision tree is very important question. Important topic. So let us discuss the theory part of decision tree first, very quickly. Okay, so now what they will provide us, they will provide us some training examples. Okay, and they will ask us to construct a decision tree for that. Okay, and then so after this training phase, after the creation of this decision tree, we can use this decision tree for the prediction. Okay, and as we know, the decision tree is one of the most widely used classification algorithm. So consider, suppose after the creation of this decision tree, the given instance is, so if we have so rain in the outlook, then mild temperature, and then normal humidity, and wind is weak. Now we want to predict using this decision tree whether we can play a tennis or not. Okay, so now in our decision tree, first we are checking the outlook. Okay, so in our decision tree, first we are checking the value of outlook. So in the given instance, the value of outlook is rain, so we will go in the right branch. Okay, then we are checking the wind, the value of wind. In our given instance, the wind is weak. Okay, so now so we'll go in this branch, and our classifier is telling that yes, you can play the tennis. Okay, and this is how we use the decision tree which is created after the training. Okay, so this is our aim. Okay, so either they will ask us to create an entire tree, or they will ask us which attribute will be there at the root level. Okay, so now we have here, this is our target, this is our class level or target, and we have total 4 attributes. This day is just an index. Okay, and we have these 4 attributes. Now which one to use at the root level? Okay, that we have to decide, and for that we want some statistical tool to determine how a particular attribute can classify the training examples. Okay, so we want a powerful attribute at the top. Okay, so that it will classify more examples. Okay, so that is our aim. So for that we are going to use one. So for that we are going to use one statistical measure known as the entropy. Okay, so the formula of entropy is, for the latecomers, so today we are going to discuss a problem based on decision tree. Okay, and we are seeing currently the formula used in ID3 algorithm. Okay, so the one of the easiest algorithm in decision tree is ID3 algorithm, and it uses these two measures, information gain and entropy. And in our textbook, the ID3 algorithm is given, so we are expecting that we will get a numerical based on ID3 algorithm. Okay, so what is the formula of entropy? So entropy of collection S, so a collection is nothing but our training examples. Okay, so this 14 instances, the collection of these 14 instances is our S. Okay, now entropy of this S is equals to summation of I from 1 to C minus probability of I log of probability of I base 2. Okay, remember here we have base 2. Okay, and now what is this C? This C is actually number of classes. Okay, so in our example, this is our target function, and see here we have two classes, no and s. Okay, so the value of C would be 2. Okay, and it will be summation from 1 to 2 minus pi log of pi base 2. Okay, so for example, for the binary classification, the formula will be, so this formula will become, so either we'll have positive example or negative example. Okay, so positive example is denoted by this symbol, okay, and negative are indicated by this symbol. Okay, it is simply a expansion of this general formula. Okay, so for binary classification, the formula would be this, minus the probability of positive examples log of that base 2 minus probability of negative example and log of that. So what is the meaning of this entropy value? So it measures the purity of a collection. Okay, so we want the entropy value to be high. Okay, then second formula is of information gain of an attribute A. Okay, so and information gain of attribute A relative to collection S. Okay, so it is denoted by this symbol, gain of A with respect to the collection S. So it is actually entropy of S minus summation of. Okay, so here we have values A. So what is the meaning of this values A? So what is A? A is actually an attribute, right? So what we are doing, we are selecting one of the attribute, right? So we want to calculate the information gain of every attribute, and we are going to select that attribute which is having the highest information gain. Okay, so values A means what? How many values are there in that attribute? So consider attribute outlook. So how many values are there? Sunny, overcast and rain. So values A is a collection of these three values. So sunny, overcast and rain. So here we will be considering every value one by one. Okay, and we will be calculating this summation. Okay. So this is a very easy formula, so you'll get used to it later on. Okay, so we have to use these two formulas only. Okay, remember, entropy is nothing but the summation of minus probability and log of same value, log of probability only, and then information gain is this value, this entropy minus this summation. Okay, so now what is the meaning of this information gain? So it measures how well a given attribute separates the training example. Okay, so this will determine the classification capability of that attribute. Okay, and we are going to select that attribute with the highest information gain value. Okay, so we are going to use these two formulas. Then we are going to use one notation, so which is denoted by this. Okay, square bracket, and we will have some value here. Okay, so now A will be the number of positive example and B will be the number of negative examples. So in our given table, how many positive examples are there? So we have total 4 instances, and out of this, 14 instances, and out of this 14 instances, we have 9 positive examples. Okay, so we will have 9 plus, okay, and remaining are the negative, so 5 minus. Okay, so we'll represent our collection with this notation. Okay, and how it is going to help us? So as we have the numbers, we can easily put the values in the entropy formula. So it will be, so we know the formula, it is probability of positive examples. Okay, so out of 14, 9 are positive. And how to calculate 14? It would be 9 plus 5, right? So from here you can calculate the values. So So it is a proportion of positive example and log of the same value minus the proportion of negative examples and log of the same value. And remember, we have log base 2, and easily you can find out the entropy. Okay, so this notation we are going to use. Okay, and then in order to simplify the calculation, we have two special cases. Okay, so if we plot the entropy value for every possible probability, okay, here we have considered the probability of positive examples. So if you plot the entropy, the graph of entropy, it will look like this. Okay, so as you can see, when the probability of this positive example is either 0 or 1, we are having entropy 0. Okay, and when the probability of positive example is 0.5, we are having the entropy 1. Okay, so these are the two special cases. Okay, so now when we are saying the probability of positive example is 0.5, the probability of negative example will be what? Anyone? Let me repeat the question. When we are saying the probability of positive example is 0.5, what would be the probability of negative example?
Anyone?
0.5. Yes, exactly right. We are talking about only binary classification, right? We have two classes, positive and negative. As we are saying the probability of positive class is 0.5, the probability of negative example will be 0.5, because the summation should be 1, right? And when the probability of positive example is 0, at the same time the probability of negative example will be 1, right? Okay, so these are the two cases. So we will have the entropy 0 if all the members of S belong to same class. Okay, so these are the two places we will have entropy 0. Okay, for example, 4 plus 0 minus. Okay, so the probability of negative example is 0, that means the entropy would be 0. Entropy is 1 when the collection contains an equal number of positive and negative examples, for example 2 plus and 2 minus. Okay, there you need not to find this log values, directly you can put 0 and 1. Okay, so remember these two cases. Okay, so now we are going to we'll try to construct this decision tree. Okay, and it is the problem from Tom Michel book. Okay, so we are the probability of getting a question based on this table is very high. Okay, so we'll try to construct this decision tree. Okay, so now is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now this is the same table. Okay, and these are the same formula. Okay, and we want to, the problem is to create a decision tree. Okay, so now these are the same formulas. So entropy of S equals to summation from I equals to 1 to C minus probability of ith class log of same value base 2. Now here in our example we have only two classes. Okay, so the formula will become the entropy of S equals to minus the proportion of positive examples log of that same probability minus the proportion of negative examples and log of that. Okay, so now let us calculate. Okay, so now total we have 14 examples, and out of that 9 are positive and 5 are negative example. So according to our notation, S can be represented by this symbol. Okay, now we'll calculate the entropy first. Okay, so it is entropy of 9 plus comma 5 minus. Okay, and just put the values in the formula. So we know that it is minus the proportion of positive example. So from here itself you can calculate. So proportion means 9 out of 14, 9 are positive. So 9 by 14 and log of same minus, now proportion of negative example, negative examples are 5, okay, 5 divided by 14 log of same value, okay, and if you calculate, you will get this value, okay. So now let me show you how to calculate log base 2, because in the calculator, you will either get log base 10 or log base e, okay. So now, so that for that, you have to utilize one log property. So we know that log of m base n is nothing but log of m divided by log of n, okay, and here you can have either base 10 or base e, okay. So similarly, so if you want to find log base 2 of 9 by 14, it is nothing but log of log base 10 9 by 14 divided by log of 2 base 10, okay, and you can find this value, this proportion, okay. So for that you have to use log property, okay, and you will get this value. The next one, now we have to decide which attribute to be placed at the root node, okay. So we have four choices: outlook, temperature, humidity and wind, okay. So in order to decide that, we are going to find the gain for every attribute, okay. So we are going to find gain for outlook, temperature, humidity and wind. So we know the formula of gain. So it is gain of attribute A relative to collection S, it equals to entropy of S minus summation of this entity, okay. So now first we are going to find the gain of wind, okay. So out of this four, we are going to find the gain of wind, okay. Just put the values. Entropy of S, it is already calculated, it is, the value is 0.94 minus summation. Now we want to find values of A. So how many values are there in the wind attribute, okay. So see here, in the wind we have weak and strong, weak and strong, only two values are there. So here I have written V belongs to either weak or strong, and rest is same, okay. Now first we will calculate, okay. So the formula will become very complicated. So first we will find this entropy value, okay. So V, initially V will be weak, okay. Put the value of V, okay. Initially V will be weak. So here I have written entropy of SV, entropy of S weak, okay. And now calculate. Now you have to consider only weak value, okay. So consider our data set. Now out of 14, how many weaks are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay. Out of 8, how many positives are there? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Out of 8, 6 are positive and 2 are negative. That's why I have written here 6 plus 2 minus. We are calculating entropy, and this notation is going to help us, right? So out of 8, 6 are positive and 2 are negative, and just put the values and you will get this entropy value, okay. So we have calculated one entropy for one of the values, okay. Now let us calculate the entropy for second, that is strong, when wind is strong. Now out of this 14, 8 are gone, so that means 6 are remaining. So calculate how many out of those 6, how many are positive. So strong, no, okay, so negative, 1, 2 and 3. Out of 6, 3 are positive. That's why I have written here 3 plus and 3 minus. And if you remember that graph, so here we have entropy and here we have probability. Now when the probability is 0.5, entropy would be 1. But here I have calculated the value manually, and as you can see, I have obtained entropy as 1, okay. So if we have equal number of positive examples and negative examples, entropy will be always 1. Okay, so the two entropies are done. Okay, then you put the values from equation 1, we'll get this is the entropy value minus, we want to calculate this ratio, that is this represent cardinality means number of elements in that. Okay, so number of elements when wind was weak was 8 divided by 14, okay, into its entropy, we have just calculated that, plus the cardinality when wind was strong was 6 divided by total quantity, that is 14 multiplied by 1. Okay, and if we calculate, we'll get gain equals to 0.048. Okay, so this is regarding one attribute. Similarly, we have to calculate the gain for remaining attributes and we will get these values. Okay, now we know that we have to select the attribute with the highest gain. So out of this, outlook is having the highest value. So we select the attribute with the highest information gain. Outlook is selected as the root node of our decision tree. Okay, so we are going to select outlook as our root node. So at this moment, so we have placed outlook at the root level, and outlook is having three values: sunny, overcast and rain. So let me show you. So outlook is having three values: sunny, overcast and rain. So we'll have three branches here. Okay, so now when we have sunny, okay, so how many instances are there with sunny value? Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and out of that how many are positive? So 1 and 2. So out of 5, 2 are positive and 3 are negative. Okay, so we have to expand this branch. Okay, then what about when outlook is overcast? Okay, outlook is overcast 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 instances, and out of that how many are positive? 1, 2, 3, 4. So our class is actually 4 plus 0 minus. Okay, so here we can terminate this branch here itself, because all the instances which will fall in this branch are positive only. Okay, so no need to consider any attribute further. Okay, so here we can directly say yes. Okay, then what about when outlook is rain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and out of that 1, 2, 3, 3 are positive and 2 are negative. Okay, that means we have to expand this branch also. Okay, so out of all, so D1 to D4, so 5 instances went in this direction, 4 in this direction and 5 in this direction. Okay, so we have to split these 5 instances, okay, and 5 these instances. Okay, so first we'll expand the left branch now. Okay, so our data set is now reduced. Okay, so we want to just expand these 5 instances: D1, D2, D8, D9, D11. So I have written a shorter version of that data set: D1, D2, D8, D9 and D11. For all these instances, the value of outlook is sunny. As you can see, it is a branch of sunny. Okay, so I have omitted that column. Okay, and this is our reduced collection. Okay, now we have to focus on this collection now. Okay, so our S is now this table. Okay, not the original one. Okay, so now we are expanding a left branch. Okay, so here we have 2 plus and 3 minus. Okay, so the entropy is this one. Okay, so using the same formula, we have calculated the entropy. Now at this moment, out of four attributes, one attribute is gone. So we have to decide which one to use at this level. temperature, humidity and wind. Okay, so to find information gain of temperature, humidity and wind. Okay, so first we'll calculate the gain of temperature. Okay, so we are repeating the same process now at the second level of the tree. So it is, now here I have inserted the values directly. So it is entropy value 0.97 minus, okay. So now we are talking about temperature, and for temperature we have three possible values. Okay, so values A equals to this set, hot, mild and cool. Okay, so now consider each value at a time. So V equals to hot. So here I have written entropy of hot. Okay, and the cardinality of S hot. Okay, then when temperature is mild, so entropy of mild, and then when temperature is cool, entropy of cool. Okay, so now we want to calculate when entropy when temperature is hot. Okay, so we have to refer this table. Okay, so we want to find, okay, how many are positive and how many are negative for the hot only. So we have 2 and both are no. Okay, so 0 plus and 2 minus, and we know that according to our graph, when we have zero, example, okay, in one of the category, the entropy would be zero, right? So it is this place. Okay, so that's why I have written directly here zero. Okay, then next is entropy when temperature is mild. Okay, so now calculate here. So 2 are mild. Okay, and here we have no and S. Okay, so 1 plus and 1 minus, and we know that when we have equal number of positive and negative example, then we have entropy as 1. So that's why I have written into 1. Okay, and how many mild are there? 2 out of 5, right? So 2 by 5 plus, now what about entropy when temperature is cool? Okay, so now we have only one instance, okay, and it is yes. Okay, so 1 plus and 0 minus. So clearly when we have 0, entropy is 0. So just put the value, okay, and this is the information gain when the attribute is temperature. Okay, so this is how that two special cases is going to help us in order to simplify the calculation. Similarly, we have to find gain when gain for the next attribute, that is humidity. Okay, and if you put the values, you will get this value, and for the wind it is this one. Okay, now compare the value. We want to select that attribute with the highest gain value. So for the temperature it is 0.57, for the humidity it is 0.97, and for the wind it is 0.01. okay, so as the humidity attribute is having the highest information gain, it is selected as the left child of the tree. Okay, so now at this moment, this is how our decision tree is looking like. At the start, we were having all the 14 instances. These are the three branches of outlook attribute, and at the left branch we have decided we are going to use humidity attribute. And now how many values are possible for the humidity? So for the humidity we have high and normal, just two. So there will be two branches. Okay, now let us see how many are there, how instances are spread out there. Okay, so when humidity is high, so for that we have to refer. Okay, so when humidity is high, play tennis is directly no. Okay, so that's why when the humidity is high, we can directly write no there. Okay, so it is like 0 plus 3 minus. Okay, and when humidity is normal, when humidity is normal, the class label is yes, okay, 2 yes, okay. So here we are having 2 plus 0 minus. So this is our terminating condition, right? Okay, so this branch is done, middle branch is also over. Now we want to expand this branch now, okay. So here also we have three choices: humidity, temperature, and one more, wind. Okay, so now to find the right child, okay, so now here outlook is rain, okay. So these five instances are having outlook equals to rain, so we are going to focus on those five instances only. So this is our reduced data set now. So first we will calculate the entropy, okay, entropy when outlook is rain, okay. So out of this, 3 are positive and 2 are negative. So this is our notation: 3 positive, 2 negative, and this is the entropy value. And okay, so it will take 15 to 20 minutes to solve this problem, and weightage will be around 10 to 15 marks. Sorry, 10 to 12 marks. Okay, so it is okay, and just you need to ensure all the calculation should be correct, okay, then you will get a full marks, okay. So, and formulas are very very easy to remember, okay. So now continuing, so here we have three choices: temperature, humidity, and wind, okay. So now we are talking about temperature, okay. So here we have, for the temperature we have three choices: hot, mild, and cool, okay. So now just refer this table, okay. So now temperature, so when temperature is hot, okay, so for hot we don't have any instance, okay. So it is a case of 0 plus and 0 minus, and in this case only we have 0, okay. So if you remember our graph, when we have equal number of entries, entropy is 1, but this is the exception, okay. When we don't have any instances, the value of entropy would be 0, okay. Then entropy when temperature is mild, okay, so mild cases are 3, and out of that 2 are positive, 1 is negative, so 2 plus 1 minus, and if you put the value, this is the final result. Now entropy when temperature is cool, so we have two instances, 1 is positive, 1 is negative, okay. So it is a case of 1 plus 1 minus, we know the value directly, it is 1. Then so gain when we select the attribute temperature, so this is the gain, and this is the gain for humidity, and this is the gain for wind. Now compare these values, we want to select that attribute with the highest gain value, so we are going to use wind here. So the wind attribute is selected as the right child of the tree. And finally our decision tree will look like this. At the top we have outlook, okay, we have talked about this left branch, middle branch. Now here we have decided to use wind, okay. So now here we had 5 attributes, okay. So now what is their split, okay. So in wind we have weak and strong, only 2 branches, okay. So here I have drawn 2 branches, okay. So now when wind is strong, strong no, so directly we can say no. When wind is weak, okay, yes, yes, and yes, okay. So here you can see when wind is weak we can directly say yes. So here we are having 3 plus 0 minus case, and when strong no, so 0 plus 2 minus, so we have 1 0 instance, okay, in one of the category. So this is our stopping criteria. So this is our final decision tree, okay. So let me show you yes, humidity, wind, okay, yes. So this is how we have to solve this problem. Okay, so this problem was very lengthy. So I guess they will ask to find out which attribute to be used at the root level. Okay, if they ask for the 6 marks or 8 marks, so we have to solve up to this point only. So let me arrange the pages. So we started with this formula. Yes. At the third place, we have decided that we are going to use Outlook is selected as the root node after finding the gain for wind, outlook, humidity and temperature. Okay. So this is regarding first problem. Now we'll discuss one more problem. Now this problem is asked twice in the university papers. For a sunburn data set given below, construct a decision tree. Okay, so how many instances are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and these are the class labels. Okay, so now this name attribute is actually just index. Okay, so we are not going to use this attribute. Okay, so we have 4 attributes total, and class label is yes and no. And we want to construct an entire decision tree. Okay, so let us find out this construct decision tree. First, entropy of, so now see the time, it is 12:09. So we'll calculate how much time it takes. Okay, entropy of collection S is given by entropy of S equals to minus P positive log of base 2 P positive minus P negative log base 2 P negative. Okay, so now our S, okay, so how many positive instances are there? 1, 2, 3. Okay, so it is 3 plus and 5 minus, right? So entropy of this equals to 3 by 8. Okay, it is a proportion of positive example. Sorry. Okay, so it is, so our collection is, we can represent using this notation. Okay, so it is log of base 2 3 by 8 minus, now proportion of negative example, so it is 5. Okay, out of 8, 5 are negative, log base 2 5 by 8. Okay, and if you want to calculate this value, so just follow minus 3 multiply by log of 3 by 8, okay, then divide by bracket 8 multiply by log of 2. I have shown you the property, minus second part, that is my 5 multiply by log bracket 5 divided by 8 bracket complete divided by bigger bracket 8 multiply by log of 2. Okay, so the value is 0.9544. okay, the value of entropy will be always positive. Okay, so even if the formula is having negative, you will get a positive value only. So this is about entropy. Now to find information gain for, so now how many attributes are there here? Height, weight and location. Okay, so we are going to find information gain for these 5 attributes. Okay, so we know that gain formula is gain for the given collection and for the given attribute. Okay, is actually entropy of S minus summation V belongs to values of A, cardinality of SV, cardinality of the given collection and the entropy of SV. Okay, so now to calculate gain of S and consider first attribute that is hair. Okay, so now for hair, how many options are there? We have blonde, brown and red. Okay, so now values A, in values A we have three values, blonde, brown and red. Okay, so we want to find entropy of this three collection first. Okay, so first we will find entropy from A. Okay, when hair is blonde. Okay, so now in the blonde, so how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, and in that how many are positive? 1, 2, yes, 2. So it is nothing but entropy of 2 plus and 2 minus. Okay, and we know that when we have, so we have total 4 blonde instances, okay, and out of that 2 are positive and 2 are negative, and we know that its value is directly 1. Okay, then entropy is, next value of hair is brown. Okay, now okay, so in brown see 1, 2, 3, and out of this yes, all are negative examples, and we know the, its value also, it is 0 directly, right? Then entropy when hair is red. Okay, so 4 and 3, only one instance is remaining. Okay, so either it will be positive or negative. Red, it is yes. Okay, so it is 1 plus, and we know the its value directly 0. Okay, just put the value. So gain of S when attribute is here is actually, okay, so entropy of entire collection is 0.9544 minus, okay, in two cases we have 0. Okay, so for the first case, okay, so cardinality of set collection when the hair is blonde. Okay, so cardinality is what? Out of 8, 4 are blonde, right? So it is 4 by 8 multiplied by 1 plus 0 plus 0. Okay, so final answer is 0.4544. Okay, so now we have calculated the gain for one attribute. Okay, similarly we want to calculate gain for height, weight and location. Okay, so now if we calculate, okay, so so I have the values directly, I will write. So for hair it is this value, for height it is 0.2656, for weight 0.0156, and for location 0.3475. Okay, it will take 5 minutes to calculate these values. and at most of the places you will get either 1 or 0. That's it. Okay, so after this, now we want to calculate, we want to compare this value. Okay, as you can see, here is having the highest information gain, so here will be selected as a root node. Okay, so as here attribute is having highest information gain, it is selected as root node. Okay, so now at this moment we'll have here at the root place. Okay, and for here we have three options: blonde, brown and red. Okay, so now when we have blonde hair, how many positive classes are there? 1, 2. Yes. Okay, so here we have 2 plus and 2 minus. Okay, so in this branch we have 2 plus and 2 minus. Okay, so 4 instances are gone. Here we had 8 instances. Okay, here we have 4 instances. In brown, how many instances are there? So brown, no. Okay, so here we have 0 positive and 3 negative. So this branch is actually over. So if you fall in this branch, you can directly say, you can directly predict no label. Okay, and what about red? Okay, so when hair is red, we have yes class. Okay, so here we have 1 plus and 0 minus. Okay, so here also you can directly say yes. Okay, so we want to expand only left branch now. Okay, so this problem is much simpler. Okay, so just we have to expand this branch now. So at this moment we have options, options of 3 attributes now: height, weight and location. Okay, so now to expand left child of the tree, in between you have to write this theory part also. Okay, then so to find information gain of, so now we have 3 remaining attributes: height, weight and location. Okay, so to find, okay, so now first we find, okay, so now here we have a branch of blonde and attribute is height. Okay, now we'll reduce our data set first. Height, weight, LOC and class label is class. Okay, in this reduced data set 4 instances will come. Okay, so now first attribute is, okay, so first row will be this one. Okay, average light, no, yes, average light, no, yes. Okay, next instance when we have hair equals to blonde is second one: tall, average, yes, no. Tall, average, yes, no. Tall, average, yes, no. Then short, average, no, yes. Short, average, no, yes. And finally short, light, yes, no. Short, light, yes, no. Okay, so this is a reduced data set and we are going to use this one. Okay, so and one thing we have forgot to calculate the entropy of this data set. Okay, so it is entropy of 2 positive and 2 negative. Okay, and when we have 2 equal instances, so probability entropy is directly 1, right? Okay, so now here we have written gain equals to gain of height attribute. Okay, so formula is entropy of S blonde minus summation V belongs to how many values are there in a height attribute. Okay, so in height we have average, tall and short. We have 3 values. Okay, so average, tall and short. SV divided by S and entropy of SV. Okay, so now first we will calculate the entropy values. Okay, so entropy value when we have average height. So here we have only one instance, okay, positive instance. So it is entropy of 1 plus 0 minus. Okay, and we know the value directly. Okay, in most of the cases you will get either 1 or 0. Then when the height is tall, okay, entropy, okay, so tall we have only one instance, that is negative. So 0 positive, 1 negative. Okay, so now we have 0 at one of the place. Okay, so it is 0. Okay, and in case of a short we have 1 plus and 1 minus. Okay, so in short we have 1 plus and 1 minus. Okay, so its entropy will be 1.0. okay, and if we put the values, so gain okay for height will come out to be 0.5 and gain for weight is 0 and gain for last one is location is actually 1. Okay, so now at this level we are going to use location attribute. Okay, so now what is our status of the decision tree? The at root level we are having here 3 branches of that. So blonde here, then brown, and then red here. Here we are having directly yes. In this branch we are having directly no. Okay, and for blonde here we are going to first check LOC, and for LOC how many values are there? No and yes. Okay, so LOC will have 2 branches, no and yes. Okay, now we have to check the split of this. Yes, so now when LOC is no, the result is yes. No yes, no yes. Okay, so here we can directly tell yes because it is a case of 2 plus and 0 minus. Okay, which is a terminating condition. And then when we have LOC equals to yes, we have no directly. Okay, again here also we can directly predict because it is a case of 0 positive and 2 negative. So this is our final decision tree. Okay, so in this way we can construct the decision tree. So now let me show you the different problems that has been asked. Okay, so here we have discussed this Sunburn dataset problem. In this problem, okay, now see, read the question. With the following dataset, generate a decision tree and predict the class label for a data point with values female to standard high. Okay, so for this instance we have to predict. Okay, so we can construct a decision tree and then we can predict the class label. Then what is the decision tree? Discuss use of decision tree for classification purpose with an example for 8 marks. Write and explain decision tree for the following transaction. Now here we have the attribute which is having a continuous values. Okay, so now till this point what we have discussed, the attributes having a discrete values. Okay, so now we'll discuss how to handle this continuous data in the next class. Okay, for the transaction shown in the table, compute the following entropy of the collection. What are the information gain of A1 and A2 related to the, okay, so this we can calculate. Discuss the decision tree algorithm. List the issue of decision tree learning algorithm. Okay, so this decision tree is very prone to the overfitting problem. Okay, so that we will discuss later on. Construct decision tree for the following data using ID3 algorithm. Okay, so this is very short problem. Okay, so we can solve that problem. Okay, so here consider the following data set for predicting outcome of tennis match between Federer and Nadal. Okay, so it is asked for 15 marks actually. So here first we have to select, we have to solve for, write the formula for information gain for an attribute, compute information gain for all the attributes which is selected as the root node. Okay, so okay, then compute the structure of decision tree computed by ID3 algorithm. Okay, so then I want to show you one more problem. Yes, it is a problem from Pune University. The following data set contains factor that determine whether tennis is played or not using naive-based classifier. Sorry, this is naive-based classifier problem. Yes, this one. Consider following table for binary classification. Calculate the root of the decision tree using Gini index. Okay, so now now they are asking to use Gini index. Okay, so now for determining the attribute to be to choose, we have used information gain here, right? Okay, so now we have another measure which is known as Gini index. Okay, so there are two popular ASM. Let me write ASM. ASM stands for attribute selection measure. Attribute selection measure. And two measures are very popular. First one is known as the information gain, which is used in ID3 algorithm, and we have seen how to use information gain in the selection of attribute. Second one is Gini index. Okay, so that we will discuss in next class. Okay, so in the next class we are going to discuss two things: how to use Gini index for the attribute selection, and second one is how to handle the numerical type of data, that is continuous type of data. Okay, so we'll stop here. Any doubt till now? I'm recording this lecture, so you can go through the recording.